The stakes are always incredibly high for any president giving his first State of the Union address. President Trump delivers his first tomorrow night. So I met up with Deputy White House Press Secretary Hogan Gidley to get a preview of the president's plans, what he's going to say, and how they apply to, let's say, young workers and dreamers right now caught in the middle of the immigration debate. Hogan, the president's going to be talking about a lot of things up on the State of the Union address. Now, we know safe and proud are two key words of this address. In a nutshell, what would you say is the state of our union?
Well, we're safer because of this president, and I think the American people have a reason to be more proud of where we are as a country. From where we were, we had just a horrible economy. Joblessness was not good. Obviously, our GDP was extremely low, and we were told for so long, it was so pessimistic, that that 1.9% GDP growth was going to be the new normal, is what we heard out of the last administration. This president comes in, and all of a sudden, the stock market goes to the roof. People with IRAs, 401ks, pension plans, all of a sudden, are starting to see an influx of money. And I talked to someone who's a middle-class American in my home state of South Carolina, and they said to me that because of what the economy has done under this president, they were able to go out and put a down payment on a truck for their farm. Hmm. And that's a real story from a real American. It's not some, ritzy top floor penthouse person. It's a real American who has benefited from this economic turn. And being proud about your country, for so long all we heard was we kind of need to be ashamed of America, it seemed like, on the global stages. The previous administration, the President Obama went and would repeatedly apologize for who we were as a nation and the way we got to our greatness. This president came in and said, it's okay that we're great. Now let's help everybody else. Let's open up our economy to other countries. We want more people here. We're just unveiling a new immigration plan.
Sure.
And it's just a very exciting time here today.
Well, let's talk about that, because actually sitting in the audience in the House of Representatives chamber are going to be a few dreamers who are going to be guests of some members of Congress.
Sure.
And we know that the White House has said, as an opening bid, 1.8 million eligible dreamers could actually earn a pathway to citizenship. This is a group of people that many Americans think should become U.S. citizens.
Sure.
It sounds like including
around
the president.
Around 80%, absolutely.
I wonder, they could be voters one day. You know, they could be citizens one day. What would the president and the White House say directly to them?
Well, just getting citizenship doesn't confer a vote. I mean, President Reagan famously gave amnesty outright and only received about 23% of the Hispanic vote afterwards. So it's not a one-for-one correlation. I believe anybody who comes to this country wants opportunity. They want the potential to be great and provide for their families. And now with a burgeoning economy like we have it, I think that points directly to the president. You see polling indicating now that people are starting to understand that, yeah, this president is in charge of the economy and he's made things happen. And now we're getting more of our own money, that type of deal. But also as it relates to immigration, I mean, talk about a great plan. I mean, most of America got to see a 55-minute meeting. It was bicameral, bipartisan, in the cabinet room.
Yeah.
And the president talked about what he wanted from immigration, and it was basically four pillars, and it was absolutely without a doubt border security. It wasn't ending the chain migration, ending the visa lottery, but he also wanted a long-lasting solution for DACA, mm-hmm. which is something that hadn't been talked about for a while. This president inherited this problem. This immigration issue has been getting progressively worse for four decades. And this president said, we have to do something to fix this, and I want to give everybody a chance who jumps through certain hoops and checks certain boxes to be citizens of this country. It's incredible. In fact, that number, that 1.8, let's not forget, that's three times the number that President Obama pushed for. Three times the number. Not to mention the fact the President Obama had the White House, both chambers of Congress, and a filibuster-proof Senate, and didn't touch the issue. This president came in the first year and said, we're going to tackle it.
Yeah, and we're going to hear on Tuesday night exactly how aggressive he is in that tone, which I think a lot of people are looking forward to. Infrastructure. Mm-hmm. And now, infrastructure is not a sexy issue. Everybody knows that, but it's an important issue.
Sure.
We've seen the White House say about $1 trillion could be going to this. A lot of people out there say we need a lot more than that. But, when I hear infrastructure, I don't so much think bridges and buildings and things like that. I think jobs, brothers, sisters, moms, dads that could be getting jobs out of this.
Sure.
What is the infrastructure plan specifically going to be talking about jobs? And I wonder about younger people.
Right.
Is this going to help younger people, maybe millennials, get jobs?
Absolutely. Well, two things. One is I can't get ahead of the president, and I can't get too detailed on what we're going to talk about with infrastructure. But it is absolutely, you know, roads and bridges are a massive part of that. Buildings are a massive part of that because, you know, you want the police to be able to come to your house and the fire department to come to your house, God forbid, if something happens.
Sure.
Roads are so bad out there. It's a cost actually on the taxpayer because they're going over potholes. It messes up their car. They have to pay for that. I mean, we have such dangerous roads and bridges in so many instances. A lot of studies out there pointing to fatalities because of where we are infrastructure-wise. And so this president wants to deal with infrastructure, but he also wants public-private partnerships as well. So it's not just all on the government to take care of. And as far as millennials are concerned, we touched on this a little bit, but to be able to have opportunity in our economy, and for the first time, the president was in Davos just recently,
yeah.
And he made the comment, we're open for business. It's America first, but it's not America alone. We want other countries to invest in our country. Now that we've lowered the corporate tax rate, we've given a tax cut to the middle America, it provides opportunity for people that wasn't there before. I saw a statistic today that said young people are actually saving more money than they ever have before. Part of that's because they live at home.
And they're scared.
And they're scared. But being able to create jobs and opportunity for people is something that's really important to this president. You've seen him as a businessman, but he wants the young people of this country to have an opportunity to succeed. And for so long, the jobs just weren't there. Now we're seeing record numbers of jobs in this country, mm-hmm. The lowest unemployment rate. The opportunity is for everybody out there, and that's what we're really looking to do.